is stronger. Praise God. All right, here we go. Number one, warmth. If we're going to communicate to somebody, if we want to really relate, remember, communication, relational communication means that we're actually bringing forth a message that is going forth as seed, and the seed is being planted, and the seed is the Word of God, and the Word of God will come back, will not come back to Him void. It will prosper to what He sent it to. So, it's important. First, warmth. Proverbs 15 and 1, it says, a gentle response diffuses anger, but a sharp tongue kindles a temper fire. One of the hardest things in the world to do when you're already mad at somebody is to take out that switchblade called sarcasm and put it up and put it in your pocket. I'm sorry, dear, did that hurt? What do you think? Dear, I'm sorry, I really was stupid. I know you are. That's not relation. That's slamming the tennis ball back. That's slamming that tennis ball back. Playing catch. So here we go. A gentle response diffuses anger, again, but a sharp tongue kindles a temper of fire. So here it is. Here it is. Warmth says, listen, warmth says you're important to me. You're valuable to me. I enjoy and respect you. I will not try to make you a carbon copy of myself, but rather I desire that you fully realize your own potential. Wow. Whoa. Husbands, try that. Wives, try that. Try that with your children. Try that with your co-workers. Wow. Because I found when I first got saved, and I want everybody to have what I had, I got to where I was trying to make a bunch of little David Linton clones. Everywhere I went, a bunch of little David Lintons. And the Lord said, what are you trying to do? There's only one David Linton. But there's a whole bunch of other people, and I want to use their unique characteristics to bring forth my word. So you just give them the word and back off and let me handle it. I'll take it from here. You know, so, I've heard Lord Timmy more than one time. Okay, I'll take it from here. Isn't it cool? I'm not responsible. I'm responsible to you. I'm not responsible for you. You're responsible to me. You're not responsible for me. Meaning that if I see my brother or my sister in a bind and I need to send them help, then it's my responsibility. If I could have things in my power to help them. And vice versa. But at the same time, I'm not just going to come in and just take over. No, God wants to use you in your own special way, and even your own spouse or your own children. You know, but DC and Daniel, sometimes it was so hard to set back, even when I literally get ready to mess up. Okay? You're not going to run any way, so just go ahead. And every now and then, they would surprise me. And I have mud on my face, which is fine. Okay, so warmth says, remember, you're important to me. You're valuable. I enjoy and respect you. I'm not going to, I can't say this enough. I will not try to make you a carbon copy of myself. I desire that you fully realize who you are, your potential in God. Number one. Number two, genuineness. I have seen over the years, I think this has been the one that not me personally having a problem with, but having a problem with somebody, you know, what they're doing, that little hidden agenda. That they come in with something else on their mind and some other way to get something, do whatever, and they swoop you in and they lower the boom on you. And there you are with your defenses down. You know, that's a bad thing. Genuineness, have no hidden agendas. Ephesians 4:15, but speaking the truth in love may grow up unto him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. Again, let me just read this. God wants us to grow up, to know the whole truth and to tell it in love, like Christ in everything. We take our lead from Christ, who is the source of everything we do. I try my best. You know, my dad is the world's worst for this. No matter what he sees, he thinks somebody's got an ulterior motive. Everybody. Well, they just did that because they want you to do such and such. They just did that because blah, 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 blah. They just did that, blah, blah. I said, Danny, do you think there might be some good people here in the world? You think there might be some people that really love God? And they're just trying to emulate God? Son, they got an ulterior motive. I said, no, son, no, Dad, no. Back up, just slow down. Let people, but see, he'd been burnt so many times. You know, so again, so I understand it. But genuine says, watch this. When somebody's genuine with you, they're saying, I'm not trying to manipulate you, nor am I trying to bend you to my will. I want to make it safe for you to communicate with me, safe for you to trust that I'll be truthful with you. That is the number one. That right there, if you've got a closed spirit, somebody's got a closed spirit, when they see this genuineness, their spirit will start opening up even more because now they're saying, look, you're not trying to manipulate me. You're not trying to make me into you. You're not trying to bend me to do what you want me to do anyway. And it's safe. A lot of people don't talk because it's not safe to communicate with them. Have you ever had somebody you're scared to talk to? I don't mean scared as if. I mean, you just hesitate to talk to them because you know as soon as you start talking to them, they're ready to fight. Okay. That is not how we communicate. You don't need to be that way. When you talk to somebody, you need to make sure, again, that they see no hidden agendas. I remember years ago, I used to tell my wife years ago, I love you, but. I love you, but. I love you, but. Whatever I say, after they were having a fight about something, I love you, but I don't like the way you do this. I love you, but I can't stand this. I love you, but. And one day, I don't know if it was a sermon. I'm not sure what it was, or maybe I was training. This was way, way on back in my 20s. And I heard him say, I love you, no buts about it. And so I do not. After that, I never again, ever said I love you, but. I mean, if I got a problem, my problems can be separated from my I love you. I love you unconditionally. That's there. I love you. Now here's that. And then I say, well, we have a problem, blah, blah, blah. But I love you unconditionally. There's no buts. Okay? So, isn't this some awesome stuff? This is absolutely awesome. This right here, if you use this right here, this little three-step formula right here, it will open up a lot of closed spirits. People will start, they won't maybe not start with, but somebody's got to see for sure that you're really conveying a warmth, you're genuine, you have no hidden agendas, and they got to know that you're empathetic. Okay? There's a difference in sympathy and empathy. Who knows the difference in sympathy and empathy? All right, go ahead.
Okay.
1 Peter 3:8, finally, all of you should be of one mind, sympathizing with one another, love each other as brothers and sisters, be tenderhearted, and keep a humble attitude. Yeah, thank you for the offering. I forgot about the offering. There you go. We got going so good there that acapella messed me up.
Everything is
awesome. Stick them up.
Okay.
Give them all you got.
Y'all remember telling y'all that about DC when he was a little thing? In church, DC was 5 years old. He was an usher, and the offering had been kind of slim. And one day, there was money coming up, falling out the plate. I looked at him, and he put that plate, looked at me, and smiled, and he put his gun and laid it on top of the offering. He had taken his little G.I. Joe gun and gone to every pew and held the gun on him. Okay. 1 Peter 3:8. Finally, all of you should be of one and the same mind, united in spirit, sympathizing one another, loving each other as brethren of one household, compassionate and courteous, tenderhearted, and humble. So empathy says, while I may not know exactly, and don't tell somebody know what you're going through. Don't tell anybody I know what you're going through. Tell somebody I can appreciate what you're going through. Because if I break my arm right here with a sledgehammer, and you break your arm right here with a sledgehammer, I still know what you're going through. Because we're going to hurt different. We've got different pain levels, different tolerances. We might have a different doctor. It might be set different. So don't tell anybody you know what you're going through. Just tell them, I can appreciate what you're going through. I have suffered this myself. And then tell me how you're feeling. Tell me how you're feeling about this. You know, if you come to me and say, look, yesterday, I get a call to a friend of mine in Emmaus. Y'all in Emmaus, y'all remember Mark Kearns? Mm-hmm. He was the guy his mama died in the last Emmaus walk. He was the lay leader. And his mama died and he come in the very last day and did his thing on Saturday night. Well, his daddy died yesterday. Mm-hmm. So it's just been a few months apart. I lost his mama and I lost his daddy. And so I talked with him yesterday morning. He was pitiful. And I talked with him. But you know, and again, I didn't say I know what you're going through. I said, you know, I can empathize with you because I remember how it was when I lost my mom and how I was lost my wife. You know, and I'm here for you, bro. I understand the pain that I went through. I don't understand the pain you're going through, but I understand the pain I went through. And I can tell you, I hated it. I felt like I had gut rot. And so you know, and then this morning I sent him a little reminder that God was in control. So empathy says, while I may not know exactly what you're going through, I'm trying to understand the emotions you feel and the challenges you face. I'm going to tell you something. If you feel, listen carefully. If you feel safe, you got to feel safe. If you feel safe to communicate with someone, especially somebody you're related to, if you feel safe to communicate with them and let your guard down, here's a good one you can ask me. Can you tell me what emotions you're feeling right now? Because it may want to kill you. And everyone would kind of say, I'd rather not tell you right now. Instead of going, you better tell me or I'm going to, okay, I want to kill you. No, just be ready. Go. Can you tell me what you're feeling right now? Please just tell me. If you don't want to, that's fine. I tell people all the time, you don't have to share. But if you will, tell me. Because I want to get a better understanding of what you're feeling right now so I can better minister to you. I hate to apply a bandage on this hand when this hand's bleeding. So please, talk to me. Explain.